Here with a new review for you guys. Today I got something that really looks cool, guys, and it is the Lucky Star. And I'm not talking about Tinfish, guys. I am talking about the RTA, guys, the dual core RTA by GMSTech, and it does look pretty good in this rainbow color, guys. And I got it sitting on top of the Wizbec Mod Active, the Wizbec Active Mod. I'll put a link into the review of this mod right there. Now, guys, this tank is really, really aesthetically pleasing, guys. So let's get down to the unboxing and let's see what this tank comes with. Guys, see you down there. Now we are down here with the GMSTech Lucky Star 2 RTA, guys. And as you can see, it is in rainbow, and the picture will match the color of the RTA, guys. Designed and manufactured by GMSTech. And these guys are the guys that brought you the Prime Mover dual core RTA. Yeah, that was pretty good as well. So I expect good things from this, guys. At the bottom, it tells you what it contains and QR code for some social media and their website. At the back is just some information about the company, some legal stuff there, made in China. And the other side, guys, you got your scratch and check and another QR authenticity code, the barcode as well. Now, let's open it up. Now, I must say the package is really attractive, guys. And as with all the products that are coming out now, it is a sleeve. Now, when you open up the sleeve, you do see a very nice hard sturdy box underneath that say GMSTech right there, and that's basically it. Reminds me of sort of a jewelry box, you know. Now you have a user manual right here, guys. Lucky Star 2 RTA, and that's the colors that you get it in. Yeah, basically, and it just tells you how to wick and just a few instructions right there. You also get a cloth there, one of these cloths to wipe your tank, to wipe the tank, guys. The star of the show right here is the GMSTech Lucky Star 2 RTA. Let's put that aside. Now you do get a 510 drip tip adapter, guys. An extra normal glass because it does come with a bubble glass in standard configuration. And a bag of goodies. Now, in this bag of goodies, you're going to get some extra O-rings, a flathead screwdriver, and some flathead screws, guys. Now, these are quite deeply cut, so it should be okay. Now, let's discuss the actual RTA, guys. Now, at the bottom here, you're going to see a GMSTech right there. CE logo, don't vape in a bin, and RTA at the bottom. Now, your positive pin here doesn't protrude at all, guys, and I wouldn't suggest that you use this in a hybrid or hybrid make mod because it's very, very slight. It's very slight, guys. Peak insulates around that positive pin, but not protruding as well, guys. Now, I did try adjusting it, and it is a non-adjustable positive pin, guys. Now, before we go further, let's get a couple of measurements, guys. Get that trusty old vernier out, and our height from drip tip to positive pin or 510 pin, you're looking at 45 millimeters, guys. Width of the base section, 24 millimeters, and width of the tank or glass section, guys, you're looking at 27 millimeters. Now, let's just take this drip tip out. You open up your drip tip, your catch cup has an inside bore of 12 millimeters, and your chimney bore is just under 6 millimeters. Guys say 5.5 millimeters. Now, this does have a 18 drip tip, but it is a reduced diameter 18 drip tip, so it should improve flavor. But these ones aren't really good with cloud production, in my opinion, guys. Now, as you can see, you do have like that star shape right there when you look at it this way, guys. And I suppose that's what they're going for, the theme of the star. Now, all around the top cap, you do have this knurling right there, so it is cut in, so it is easy to actually grip and open this tank. Now, when you do open it up, juice inlet ports is quite big, and you shouldn't have any problems getting a glass dropper in there, or even just pouring the juice in, guys. Now, what's nice about this is that your inlet port is recessed, so you don't have juice coming out over the sides when you're actually closing up your top cap, guys, or closing up your tank by putting your top cap on, which is really a pro in my book, guys. Now, let's put this back on here. And let's talk about the airflow, guys. Now, you do have three diamond-shaped airflow slots on either side, so six altogether, guys. And you do have this diamond knurling here to actually open and close that airflow with stoppers when you open and close it, guys. Now, as you can see, the lucky star, or the star that's engraved there, so it's supposed to be reminiscent of the Lucky Star 2 RTA, guys. So let's open it up. Let's have a look inside. Now, when you look inside, guys, as you can see, nice doming going on here, guys. Really nice doming going on, and a nice compressed chamber. So you should get a lot of flavor, or decent flavor from here, but we will check it out when we go up top and vape it, guys. Now, let's put this aside. The deck on this, guys. Now, let's get this into a bull stand. Now, the deck on this is a really unique deck, in my opinion, guys. Really nice looking deck as well. As you can see, you're going to have a slot for each one of your legs. So, you mean you're not going to be sharing coil leads. And it's a velocity deck, guys, but it's more uniquely placed, in my opinion. So you have your post screws coming through at an angle here, just like that. So sort of like the prime mover, and then you have two extra post screws on the top, guys. So you can actually do like a bottom top configuration, or top top, depending on the size of your coils, guys. Now, when you look down to the airflow, now it is a bottom, direct bottom airflow. Depending on how you place your coil, you could get a bit of side airflow as well, guys. Now, it is in the shape of the bow tie, where your airflow slots are cut out, and I must say, very neat looking deck. And the machining of the actual RTA in hole was very, very good, guys. Now, wicking slots or channels aren't the biggest in the RTA game, but it should be sufficient for this tank, guys, in my opinion. You do have four of them on either side of the deck, guys. Now, gold-plated deck, as you can see. Positive post will be on this side with the peak insulator around it and under it, guys. Now, let's get some coils and let's throw a build in here. Now, today we are going to be using some Chainlink NI80 coils, guys. Description of the coils will be in the video description below. Now, let's coil up the RTA, guys. Now, let's get our flathead screwdriver firstly. I'm using the Coil Master one because it makes life a whole lot easier. And let's just open out these post screws, guys. I must say, I have been using this RTA on and off for about 2 to 3 weeks, ever since VapeCon ended, because I did get it at VapeCon 2018, guys. And I haven't had any issues with these flathead post screws, I must say, or the post for that matter, bending or whatever, guys. Now, the posts are all open. Let's throw in the bill, guys. Now, because you can actually have one coil lead for each coil. It'll make life a whole lot easier here, guys. Now let's just grab that there and tighten down. And let's do the other side as well. If we can get in a slot, get in a slot. That's it. Make sure that's tightened down. And I actually tightened down the wrong post screw on the top. Did you guys actually see that? Yep. Now, let's just trim these leads, guys. Now, watch your eyes in you doing this. Now, get it as close to the deck as you can, guys. And with this deck, it will allow you to get real up and close, guys. Now, grab your coiling rod. Let's just position this coil so we can make life a bit easier, guys. And right there should be fine for now to get the second coil in. Now, let's slot in the second coil. Just like that. And let's tighten it down, guys. And the diagonal screw. Now let's just trim the legs, guys. And the other one. And as you can see, guys, really easy to actually get in there. Hey? Really, really easy. Now let's just position this coil. Try and get it as close to that airflow without touching, guys. Same on this side. And that should be good. Just like that, guys. Now, let's dry fire these coils and take out the hotspots. And to do that, we are going to be using the Wismec Active 80 Watt mod. And I think it looks nice together with the rainbow and this particular sleeve, guys. Now let's just get it on here. Just like that, guys. Now let's turn down this wattage. Firstly, let's power this off. And I always like to check this first, guys, because remember, your preheat will be on sometimes. And you always want to check that it's off. As you can see, it was off there, guys. Because I always notice that people forget to do that, especially reviewers, when they are dry firing coils and stuff. And it is a very important part, because especially when you like dry firing stainless steel and stuff, I mean, you can't do so high wattages, guys. And let's go to like 25 watts here. As you can see, this scrolls really fast. 25 watts, grab the ceramic tweezers, and let's pulse these coils, guys. And let's get some heat into them first. Now, I don't know if you can see it, but it is heating up, guys. Let's just raise the wattage a bit. 30 watts should be okay. As you can see, it's heating up. Now, let's give it a bit of a strum, guys. This should be fine because it is spaced out a bit, guys. Let's just get some heat in there. Just wanna strum that this side as well. Let's pulse it again. Give it a strum while you're pulsing. And as you can see, guys, it's heating up nice and evenly. Nice coloration on the coils with the gold background. Really looks nice. Now, we're going to leave these coils to cool down, guys. And when we come back,
We will wick it up, juice it up, and see how it vapes.
See you when we return.
Now that the coals have cooled down, let's wick it up. And today we are using some Cotton Bacon Prime, guys, by Wick and Vape. And this is awesome cotton, guys. Now, let's wick it up. Now, you just want to taper out a strip. I have taken it out already. Just taper it down properly. That's what you want to do. Make sure it's done properly. And let's just get it through here, guys. So, just get it through like that. And just pull through how much you need, guys. And that should be sufficient right there. Now just trim off the extra or excess. And let's do the same on the other side, guys. Just like that. Now let's just trim off the excess here. And here as well, guys. And let's fluff, just grab your elbow tweezers to fluff it out. Now just put your finger behind it to support. Just want to comb it out, guys. Make sure those fibers are nice and straight. And this one you do want to actually comb out quite well, because you don't have really very big juice wells, guys, or wicking wells. Now let's cut or trim our cotton, guys. And I suggest you actually put your scissor on where this O-ring sits, or where the glass will sit, and take your measurement from there, guys. And basically, you just want to trim. And the same on the other side, guys. Now, guys, let's just get one to test, one edge to test. And let's just slot it in there. Make sure all the fibers are nice and straight, guys. You do this. And the length looks perfect. Now let's do the same with the other side, guys. Make sure all the fibers are nice and straight. And if you're not sure, just run your one inside of your tweezer in there to make sure it's nice and clump free. Now, guys, let's do the same on this side. So I get that in there. Run the one edge of your tweezer down in there to make sure it's nice and clump free. And this one is looking a bit long, guys. I just want to trim this. Just eyeballing it. That looks better and straight. Now let's get this in here. Make sure you get all the fibers nice and straight in there, guys. And you should be good. Now, let's get some juice and let's juice it up, guys. Today, we are using some Mr. Hardwick's or watermelon candy, 3 milligram Nick liquid. Let's juice it up. Now, this is Cotton Bacon Prime, guys, so you shouldn't have any problems absorbing all of this delicious liquid, guys. You all love the way this liquid smells. It's absolutely amazing, guys. Really, really, really amazeballs. Okay, now let's juice this up really well. Make sure it gets all that good liquid in there. Now let's turn up our wattage to about, say, 60 watts. That's good. Now let's put our pre-ovens. Now that's cool. You can fire it like this for now. Now, just get a bit more juice on there, because it does seem a bit dry when you fire in it. That looks a bit better. Now, just, you want to grab a lighter, guys. And this will get rid of the stray fibers and get dissipate the cotton taste. So what you want to do is actually fire the RTA and just bring a flame to it and blow it out, guys. As you can see, it got rid of most of those stray fibers, and it would get rid of most of the cotton taste. Anything else will dissipate within the first hit, guys. Now, let's put on the top cap or tang section. And let's open up the top cap. Make sure airflow is closed first. Top cap open up, guys. Now let's fill up the tank, guys. Now almost there. And that should be good right there, guys. Now grab our top cap. Top cap on. Make sure it's nice and tight on there to complete that vacuum. Now let's open up the airflow, guys. And let's take it up top and see how it vapes. See you up top, guys.
Hey, guys. Now we're back up top here with the freshly wicked and juiced Lucky Star 2. RTA, guys, true called RTA. Now, I did switch out mods. I got in trouble with the Vupu Alpha 1 because my battery did die in the Bluetooth mod. Listen to music, guys. What can I say? Now, let's actually talk about this for a challenge. Let's talk about what you have here for a challenge, guys. Let's talk about the Lucky Star 2 RTA. Let's have a vape and see how it vapes. Really, really nice flavor I'm getting from here, guys. Really good flavor. And I know how this juice tastes. I'm using Mr. Hardwick's Watermelon Candy, 3 milligram nick juice, guys. And it is ohming out at 0.23 ohms with that dual chain link coil in there. And I got it at 61 watts, guys. 61 watts I'm vaping. Very nice flavor, very, very nice flavor, I must say, guys. For flavor, I have to give it a 7 out of 10. Now, in terms of cloud production, in my opinion, I don't see this being a dense cloud chucking tank simply because of that really compressed chamber. I see it being more of a flavor tank. And the bubble glass configuration is just there for more liquid capacity. Now, I'm not sure if you guys know this, but for example, certain bubble glasses allow the tank to perform better in terms of vapor production. One of those is the Manta RTA. Another one is the Bravo RTA. Guys, you'll get more vapor production if you use the bubble glass. And I think the reason for that is because it allows the tank to breathe. Now, with this, I'm not getting that, guys. I really have to amp up the wattage to actually get a denser vape. Now I'm gonna put it up to 75 watts. More of a denser vape, much more flavor, but a bit too hot for my liking, guys. So let's turn it back down to say 62, 63 watts. Let's go 65 watts, guys. Cloud production, I have to go a 6 out of 10. But what I am happy about is that it's one of the first dual coil RTAs that I have that the vapor doesn't completely drown out the flavor. I'm getting good flavor here, guys. And I really think that I'll use this RTA for a long time to come. Simply because it looks really nice, firstly. Secondly, it reminds me of Tin Fish. Yeah, guys. Now, we South Africans love our Lucky Star. Anyway, guys, that's my opinion of the tank. Let me know of your opinion down in the comment section below. And if you like this video, then hit that like button and subscribe to my channel for daily vape reviews. That's Vaping Mofo. out.